Hi, my name is Zaim Skanda. As usual, I will introduce myself first before I start all my videos. And yeah, this video will be relating to the Schumacher dynasty. Yeah. Firstly, it will not be related to Schumacher's younger brother, Ralf, but it will be related to him. As in my Michael. So yeah, his son Mick is going up the ranks to GP2, F2 after winning the F3 championship this year. He had a great second half of the season in at the his respective championship. I can't wait for him to step in F2, but there's something I'm curious about. Firstly, is he connected to Mercedes or Ferrari? Because the head of recruitment, young drivers recruitment for Ferrari, is a son to the FIA, and and his name is Nicholas Todd, the son to the FIA. So Dato' John Todd is the FIA president. I would prefer to call him John Todd only, because it feels weird calling him Dato'. Seriously, it feels weird calling him Dato', because I'm used to watching F1. So it doesn't sound right if I call him Dato'. So because I'm and he was actually the former team principal of Ferrari before he became the FIA. So John Todd, I think it's somewhere in 2009. So his son, Nicholas Todd, is actually the agent to Mick. Mick is in F2 driving for Prima. One of Prima's main sponsors is Ferrari. So chances of him getting into a Ferrari and into a Mercedes is 50-50. I'm not sure, but I have a feeling leaning towards Ferrari. But the problem is the other two Ferrari development drivers, Giovinazzi, Antonio Fiocco, and the other two F1 drivers, Giovinazzi and Leclerc, was from the driver development program for Ferrari, and even one of the F2 drivers by the name of Antonio Fuoco. He's Italian, so I couldn't pronounce his name, but he's from F2. Antonio Fuoco, Fucco, Fuoco something. Yeah, I think he will be mixed teammate. But those three drivers that I mentioned, barring from Mick, they were literally they were directly abstracted from the driver development program for Ferrari. So I am not sure whether Mick Schumacher is in the Ferrari development program or his agent is connected to Ferrari. When I say his agent, in bracket, is Nicholas Todd, the son of the FIA John Todd. So John Todd's son is I think the head of recruitment for Ferrari. I'm not so sure about that, but what I'm sure is he's the agent to Mick Schumacher. But he's related to Ferrari, Nicholas Todd. So yeah, hopefully chances of seeing him in a civil aero or even in a scarlet car is 50-50, because I'm not sure whether the rumors are true. Rumors has not started yet, but I think next year if he starts winning races in F2, rumors will be flying in like flies, or like bees sucking out honey from nectar from plants to make honey. So yeah, so bees, I mean, yeah. So to sorry to produ not to make honey, to produce honey, sorry. Yeah, so I can't wait for the rumors to be like flying bees looking for nectar to produce honey on mixed career into F1. So it will happen if he starts winning races actually. So yeah, hopefully. But the Schumacher name is a dynasty because his uncle and his father used to race it in F1, and his cousin David Schumacher is slowly and going up the ranks into the F3 championship. His mixed cousin David Schumacher. So they might be a Schumacher dynasty, part two of the Schumacher dynasty in next 10 years. So yeah. Hopefully, yeah, he's in the, I think he's in the British Formula 3 Championship or the European Formula 3 Championship. Not the Formula 3 Championship itself, the European Formula 3. That means it's only concentrated in Europe for David Schumacher, but for Mick Schumacher it's concentrated all over the globe, including races like Italy. Yeah, Italy, all those races. But F2, I couldn't wait to see his F3 rival racing against him in F2. So yeah, and I think he's also a British driver, Tickham, Daniel Tickham, and he is related to the Red Bull driver's program for Red Bull. Yeah, hold on. Yeah, so if he starts winning races, he'll put one of the Toro Rosso drivers under pressure. I'm talking about Tickham. So yeah, congratulations to Schumacher, Mick Schumacher and Daniel Tickham to fogging up the ranks into F2. But I assume that Ferrari in the next few years would have the same problem with Red Bull about 7 years back, and most recently with Mercedes. If they start creating a lot of academy drivers, they start producing a lot of academy drivers, they might not find a seat for Mick Schumacher. So Mick Schumacher might have to drive for Sauber first. But let's see if Antonio Fiocco wins the championship, and I think he's driving a Prima, Fiuco. He's Italian, Antonio Fiuco. He is also a Ferrari development driver. I don't know who is his agent, but for sure Mick Schumacher's agent is related to Ferrari. Mick Schumacher's agent's name is Nicholas Todd, as you guys know. I'm trying to pinpoint the points here, but I'm still stuck because surely he will have to choose between Ferrari and Mercedes, Mick Schumacher. But if he could get the 2020 seat for beside Raikkonen, in Sauber, that will create a big problem for Ferrari, because Raikkonen signed a 2-year contract with Sauber, so I think it's a sabbatical contract, so he might leave the seat open to Mick Schumacher, but chances of him leaving the seat vacant for Schumacher's son, it's there, but I'm not sure whether it's a high chance or not, but maybe it's a high chance. But hopefully Ferrari will not have the trouble of Mercedes now and like Red Bull 7 years ago when they 10 years ago when they had a ridiculous amount of talent. Like Mercedes, they have a ridiculous amount of talent, but instead of putting Ocon alongside Hamilton, they decided to stay with Bottas beside Hamilton. Sadly, now Ocon does not have a seat, but he will be testing the simulator for the Silver Arrows. So he will have simulator time for the car, for the team. I'm talking about the Mercedes team. So I'm trying to connect the dots between Mercedes, Ferrari, and the agent for Mick Schumacher's agent, Nicholas Todd. I'm trying to connect the dots, but I am always stuck in a cul-de-sac. Everywhere I look, everywhere I think, doesn't add up. I would prefer him to be in a Sauber in 2020, but if Raikkonen decides to take a sabbatical role in Sauber like he did with Ferrari when he left the spot he did not take a sabbatical role. He left the spot in 2009, Raikkonen, like Schumacher did in 2007 with Ferrari when Raikkonen was there in his first team. Schumacher took a sabbatical role to become the team's advisor. I think Raikkonen will do the same if Ferrari wants to see Mick Schumacher driving beside him. But they might have a problem displacing Giovinazzi, because unless Giovinazzi can jump into a Ferrari, but for that to happen, Vettel has to make his seat vacant. Ouch. Make his seat vacant for Giovinazzi, but I assume he's not going to do that until the end of 2020. So Giovinazzi will be stuck in Sauber for 2 years. But if Antonio Fiocco is in F1 and Ferrari would, there's a few Ferrari development drivers here, but I think he in 2020 he as in Kimi would take a spectacle role in the Sauber team for a season and then manage it a year later. But I still have a problem. I still have to connect the dots between Mick Schumacher's agent and Mercedes and Ferrari. But I couldn't seem to connect it for some reason. So hopefully if he starts winning races, rumors will fly in like a flock of bees trying to trying to suck nectar out of a plant to make honey. So yeah, I can't wait for him to start winning races in F2 especially. I'm talking about Mick Schumacher. Danny Tikum, I think he has had his seat secured with Toro Rosso if his super license is enough. But with the Red Bull Academy driver Daniel Tikum will not have a problem. Because Red Bull is not like 10 years ago. 8-10 years ago, because back then they produced a lot of top talents, but they had to release them. Like, for instance, Eric Vern, now he's in F2, sorry, Formula E now, and battling with the likes of Heifel, a lot of former Formula 1 drivers in F2, including Massa next year, including Stoffel Vandoorne. So Vern used to be from the team. Jean-Éric Vern used to be a Red Bull junior driver from the Red Bull Academy, but Red Bull had a lot of good talents back then. They had to let Alguersuari go, Alguersuari go, they have to let Vern go, they have to let Kvyat go, and a few other drivers go. Yeah. Mercedes is the other team. They couldn't find a corner seat. Ocon does not have a seat, so they throw Ocon in a simulator for next season, for the whole season. So sadly, Ocon will not be on the track. So racing on the track, he will be in the simulator doing simulator testing. So yeah, as so I think that Ferrari would have the same problem as currently Mercedes have and Red Bull 8 to 10 years ago. Red Bull and Mercedes in the last decade, they have the same problem. They have too much of talent to project themselves into the team until they have to not kick the drivers out. The drivers had to move into a different spot first before they could jump into the team, before they could drive for the team. Ocon did not want to leave F1. Now he sadly he will be in the simulator for the whole of next year. Seriously, sad. Ocon has talents. They should at least allow Ocon to be alongside Lewis, but I think Lewis will dislike that. Or in bracket, they are afraid that Ocon is, I'm not going to use the word young, too inexperienced to deal with Hamilton. Seriously, how many years Ocon has been in F1? He can deal with Perez, why can't he deal with Hamilton? Right, so yeah. Kvyat, he spent less than a season in Toro Rosso, then he was projected up to Red Bull, so he was culture shock in Red Bull. That's why his performance was really bad in his first stint with Red Bull. Kvyat, the Russian, or I nicknamed him the Torpedo for one particular reason, but I will not mention it in this video. Maybe in the Australian Grand Prix preview video, maybe in March next year. So yeah. So yeah, the likes of Vern, the likes of Jimmy Akosari, and a few other drivers that were from the Red Bull Academy 10 years ago. Only Vettel managed to go from Toro Rosso to Red Bull to Ferrari. The others either kicked out of the, not kicked out, sorry, they are forced to move to another not team, another category in single seater racing, or even maybe they are doing DTM, or they are doing other types of single raters single seater racing, like John Erickson. He used to be related to the Red Bull team because he was from the Red Bull Academy, but he was in 2014-2015, there was no Formula E, or before 2014-2015 there was absolutely no Formula E. Formula E just came in like 2016 Formula E came in, so he had nowhere to go until a Formula E team came calling for his services. He was released by Red Bull for quite a long time, and he was also the test driver for Toro Rosso. Then he moved to Formula E a couple of years ago, a few years back, sorry. Now he's playing trade in Formula E and he's winning championships. So hopefully Ferrari will not turn out like what Mercedes and Red Bull turn out, because Mercedes are starting to have a lot of really really good racing talents. Let's see, Russell does well enough, what will happen to Ocon? Ocon will not get Bottas' seat. Even let's say if Vettel doesn't retire after 2020 season, what will happen to Antonio Giovinazzi, Antonio Fiocco, or even Mick Schumacher if he gets a chance to be in F1 for you. Antonio Fiuco might get a chance in 2020 if Raikkonen decides to take the sabbatical role. But if Fiuco and who's that guy? Mick Schumacher. What either one wins the championship, who would Ferrari want to put in Raikkonen's seat? Fiuco or Schumacher himself? I'm talking about Michael Schumacher's son, not the legend. The son of the legend. So yeah. So unless Fiuco has a contract with Haas, but Haas doesn't want any relations with Ferrari. So Ferrari might be stuck in a cul-de-sac in the next few years with Mick Schumacher and Fiuco. But if they decide to upgrade Antonio for 2020, Giovinazzi for 2020 to partner Leclerc is okay. But if after 2020 Vettel doesn't retire from the spot, Ferrari would have a huge problem with Fiuco, Giovinazzi and Mick Schumacher one of them should become the test driver. One of them should be a test driver for the team. But I seriously doubt Fiuco to be. If Mick Schumacher would have an easier bet to become Giovinazzi's teammate, because in 2020. But the problem is, if and Fiuco, that will upset Fiuco, and that makes Raikkonen have a headache. Yeah, if he takes a sabbatical role as a not team manager, as the owner of the Sauber team in 2020, he would have a big driver situation in that team, especially with Schumacher and Fiuco himself, because Fiuco is, I can guarantee you, is related to Ferrari. But Mick Schumacher can either join Ferrari or even can join Mercedes. But I have a feeling he is nearer towards Ferrari. But that would make Fiuco a test driver for Sauber. Unless Giovinazzi will replace Vettel after 2020. Chances are that there will be a possibility, but I'm not sure how big is the possibility. Yeah, hopefully Vettel takes a sabbatical role in Ferrari after 2020. But if he doesn't win a championship with Ferrari, I think he would still not take that role for in so Sauber is stuck in a cul-de-sac for the seats in post-2020 season. Yeah, really stuck in a cul-de-sac, Sauber. So, yeah. Because of Mick Schumacher and Fiuco. Fiuco, I think, is, as you guys know, I'm repeating again and again about Fiuco. Schumacher, oh, that is a really tough decision, because the agent to make is related to Ferrari. Raikkonen is related to Ferrari. Vettel is related to Ferrari. But Vettel is the currently the Ferrari driver. Giovinazzi is the development driver for Ferrari. Antonio Fico is also the development driver for Ferrari. But hopefully has decided to take Fico. Antonio Fico, the Italian from F2, to the team. But Haas doesn't want to have any relations with Ferrari, unless regarding the drivers, regarding the Ferrari development drivers, not regarding power units and any technical system. Regarding drivers, they don't want to have any connections with Ferrari. So if Raikkonen takes a sabbatical role, he can be a part-time driver. He can be a part-time test driver, and also own the Sauber team. But the problem is, if he is a part-time test driver, and Giovinazzi doesn't move up the rank to Ferrari, Fuyuko is Giovinazzi's teammate for 2020. Then Mick Schumacher? There's also a chance of Mick going into Mercedes, but chances are Mercedes has a lot of exceptional talent in their ranks, the likes of Russell, the likes of Ocon, and the likes of other Mercedes drivers, Mercedes development drivers. So well, no choice. But still, I can congratulate Danny Tickham and Mick Schumacher for going up the ranks into F2. Danny Tickham will not have a problem, because Red Bull has limited the production of young talents, but Ferrari might have a problem in the next couple of years with young talents coming in, like flies. Yeah, so hopefully they will not be like an Ocon or a Vern or Hartley was also 10 around 8 to 10 years ago was also related to the Red Bull Academy driver. But Helmut Marko released Hartley, released Ocon, Kvyat stayed on. But after the antics of the 2016 Russian Grand Prix, it was downgraded to Toro Rosso, and Vern was his teammate, if I'm not mistaken. After 2016, Vern left. So yeah, Max was Vern, Vern, John Eric Vern. No, Verstappen. Vern, yeah. Not Verstappen. Vern, John Eric Vern. So, I. Yeah. Red Bull will not have a problem with their talents because. Yet. But, like. Like Mercedes, they have a couple of drivers. For instance, Ocon now is a test and development driver for the team. Yeah, was, but now he is actually a simulator driver for the whole of next year. Hopefully Ocon can be ready for 2020. But what happens if Ocon Russell does a better job than Ocon and gets the 2020 seat to partner Hamilton? Leave the comments down below, please. So, we are concentrating on Mick Schumacher's career in F1. But, yeah, and this video is about Mick Schumacher winning the championship and is him and his rival going up into F2. But, chances are he will be going to... There's a possibility of Schumacher going to Ferrari and going into Mercedes. But Mercedes, as you guys know, they have exceptional talent. The pronunciation. Exceptional, yeah. So I can't wait, but hopefully Raikkonen takes this sabbatical role. But that will still be a problem if, for some whatever reason, Mick is connected to the team, to Ferrari, because of his agent Nicholas Todd. Ferrari would have a huge headache who to put in beside Giovinazzi for 2020, unless Vettel retires after 2020. It's okay, but if Vettel plans to extend his stay in F1, so how? Please leave the comments down below and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, Zaim's channel, and please press the notification bells, because I still couldn't connect the dots between Mick Schumacher, Ferrari and Mercedes-Benz. Yeah, so do leave your thoughts down below about Schumacher's career path into F1, about his future career path when he enters F1. So yeah, but still, before I end, before I say goodnight, I'll have to congratulate him for his win and for Danny Tickham being really really good rival in F3 for him. Yeah, they will be racing in F2 next year. Danny Tickham and Mick Schumacher. Yep, they are from Germany and UK. Britain. Tickham is from Britain. Mick is from Germany. So yeah, I can't wait to see. So I will be following F2 next year because of those two drivers. But yeah, don't forget to leave your thoughts about the career. Mick Schumacher's career path in F1. Yeah, career path when he enters F1 down below. And again, I have to sign off. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and press the notification bell below. And I'm signing off by saying good night.